Welcome to Config Ninja blog post. Today is a Halloween day of 2013. So I've been working for a couple of days in several things. One of them has been upgrading my lab, and I know some of you guys have been things. So I created just this video for a little reminder. So the first thing we're doing here in OurCast is removing our Windows ADK to make sure I can upgrade to Configuration Manager 2012. But there are a few things we have to remember besides removing ADK and having that upgraded. So in my case, I'm upgrading from 2008 R2 to Windows Server 2012 R2 also. So I'm going to be removing the ADK before my upgrade. But there's a couple other things I have to remove from this Windows Server too. One of the other things that we'll remove is actually SQL Server reporting services, because I'm going to upgrade from SQL Server 2008 to SQL Server 2012 SP1. So let's go ahead and wait here for my Windows ADK to do the prereq installation before I start the operating system upgrade. So this ADK that we are installing in here, we just want to make sure we have it compatible. We have a compatible version of the ADK. There are a few things that have been upgraded in terms of the ADK for this version of Configuration Manager 2012 R2. So we got to just make sure that we install the things that we need. We only need deployment tools. We only need Windows pre-installation services and user state migration. So we're not going to need a SQL Server or performance tool, at least not for this Configuration Manager server. So let's take these three out and then select USMT, which is one of the other things we will need. So this installation may take a few minutes depending on what you do. My recommendation is you guys should download the Windows ADK ahead of time so you avoid taking a delay on the installation. So that's just my recommendation in there. So I got everything ready here, upgrade. I just want to make sure I got the ADK downloaded, SQL, and everything are ready in here. All right, once we have everything already extracted from the R2, one of the first things that I recommend you guys do is to some of those redistributed files that Configuration Manager R2 is going to need. So let's go to x84 inside the SMS setup and find the setup downloader. Setup downloader will download these pre-requirements to a specific folder. The benefit of doing this ahead of time is that you can reuse this downloads as many times as you need. So let's go ahead and start the download process of the pre-requirements. Please note also the location where you download these files, because we're going to use them once we finish the installation of the operating system. We're going to do that as part of our R2 installation. Okay, so we have everything ready. One of the things that I want to do is upgrade my operating system. Windows Server 2012 R2 was just released. So I want to take advantage of this operating system. So one of the first thing I will do is upgrade my operating system to Windows Server 2012 R2. Again, I'm doing this on my lab. I want to test out if there's any issues or anything going on with Windows Server 2012 R2 and my lab. So in your case, I recommend you guys doing the test in the lab environment too. Just kind of like test out the operating system. Not all the operating system upgrades will be seamless or in a smooth way. So make sure you guys do that. Okay, so make sure you select here the right operating system upgrade. I want to make sure it's a Windows Server 2012 R2 standard with GI. So yeah, I don't want to do the core installation, right? Once I do this, I can definitely go up and do a change, but we want to make sure everything goes well as we need to, right? Great, so it's doing a couple of compatibilities. This upgrade may take some time. It depends on. All right, just checking for compatibility to make sure everything is doing well. Okay, so we are now start doing the operating system upgrade. This upgrade may take quite a few times, so we don't want to wait you guys here for the next couple of minutes while the upgrade is happening. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pause here, edit, and go as fast as I can. This is going to be the speed of light upgrade, all right? All right, so the installation just finished here. Thanks for the editing software. This was the speed of light, right? So great, let's wait here till the operating system finished. One of the first thing I wanna do is install upgrade or SQL Server from 2008 R2 to SQL Server 2012 Service Pack 1. So let's go ahead and start doing that process. We just got the operating system upgraded. Now I wanna do SQL Server, and after I do the SQL Server upgrade, I'm gonna do System Center Configuration Manager. Okay, so here we are upgrading our SQL Server from 2008 R2 to 2012 Service Pack 1. This will take a few times, so I was just wanted to highlight here that that's what we are doing, right? We're going to be selecting the right instance to upgrade, and we're going to click Next in here, and we're going to go through the process of upgrading SQL Server 2012. Okay, so as far as my upgrade from SQL Server 2008 R2 to SQL Server 2012, I have to remove reporting services. For some reason, reporting services throw me ability mode when doing the upgrade. So I'm going to remove it first, and then I'm going to upgrade the rest of the services, and then I'm going to restore. I'm going to basically install the services back. Since I'm going to be upgrading the reports, I shouldn't have any problems. I only have configuration manager reporting here. So let's remove reporting services and then perform the final upgrade. All right, so SQL Server reporting services was removed. Let's go ahead and perform the upgrade now from SQL Server 2008 R2 to SQL Server 2012. Right, so we are here upgrading on SQL Server. We just grabbed the right instance to do the upgrade. So we're going to wait for the SQL Server to be upgraded. So during the next few minutes, we're going to be upgrading our SQL Server before we go ahead and upgrade our Configuration Manager. So let's click Next in here, wait for Server to come back, and tell me what are the different things that I got to select. Let's give it a minute in here, and then let's move forward. Okay, so our SQL Server 2008 has been upgraded to 2012. So let's move on to the next step. One of the other steps is to upgrade everything to Service Pack 1. I didn't have it as part of my Configuration Manager server, so I'm going to go ahead and do that. Okay, select the Service Pack 1 hotfix, and let's run the hotfix in here. All right, so my Service Pack 1 just finished installing, has upgraded my SQL Server instance, and everything is ready to roll for the next step. So since we removed SQL Server reporting services early on, my next step will be to add SQL Server reporting services back to this configuration, to the SQL Server, so I can use it later for Configuration Manager. So let's go ahead and add reporting services back to this Configuration Manager server. Okay, so everything is ready here. I just want to validate and confirm that my configuration manager server is up and running before going to R2. As you can see, my configuration manager 2012 CAS is up and running here, still not R2. So what I'm going to do next is upgrade configuration manager 2012 to R2. Okay, so in here in the splash, we have click install. And the next step is gonna tell us, hey, we're gonna upgrade to configuration manager 2012. So stay with us for a few minutes. This part, I'm gonna leave it run for the rest. So I'm gonna click next in here, and I'm gonna select upgrade this configuration manager site. That's how I'm gonna upgrade the configuration manager site server. We gotta remember that we gotta upgrade from top down. So this is my CAS server. So I'm gonna basically install this first before I can actually do the upgrade. So let's go ahead and perform that upgrade now. It's gonna select evaluation. I got around 180 days to do my evaluation. If you ever have to do that before getting the license, feel free to do that. You can then change it out, the licensing code later on. So I'm gonna agree to the agreement here. Let's agree to disagree, right? All right, let's select every single license. There is no other option. You have to agree to all the licensing because otherwise you will not be able to upgrade. So let's use the previously downloaded on the video. Remember, we download some of the redistributed files. So let's select those redistribution files and click next in here. That's one of the benefits to download everything ahead of time. So once you download it, you will have it ready here for you. So you don't have to wait for the download process. So this step is going to validate the different files that have been downloaded, and we can be able to continue. So the next step is adding any new languages to my system. I don't have any other languages other than English. Of course, you can add Spanish, French, Portuguese, whatever you need. But this moment, I don't need any other language other than English. So I'm just going to click next in here. Same thing, you know, the one was a server license, a language, and now it's a client language. So we're going to click next. We're going to validate that my server meets all the requirements. In my case, I have an add AWS US, so I'm going to add that later. So don't worry about it. We can just keep going in here. Publishing to AD, I think it's very important. You got to make sure that you're able to publish everything to Active Directory. Otherwise, you're going to have some conflict. SQL Server memory is very important, guys. You know, we need to set up the memory at 8192 for every single server. The maximum memory for some of the servers may be 10 gigabytes, 10/1/24, or something like that. I'm very bad at math, and some of you guys may know that already. So I'm now just big installation. Once I begin the installation, I'm going to open CMTrace. With CMTrace, I'm going to be able to monitor what are the different things I'm being installed at that moment. So I'm going to drop it on my system 32. I like to do that all the time for my server. So I'm going to go ahead and do that now. Yes, if this was an image, I'd probably do it too to all my images. I need CMTrace most of the time. So here we are. We're installing and upgrading the configuration manager. So let's go ahead and look at that log file in a few minutes. All right, so this installation normally takes around 45 minutes. So let's set the clock, stop, and back to the future. All right, so I finally upgrade everything to R2. I'm just finishing doing the upgrade of my secondary site server. As you can see, I got my CAS up and running with R2. My primary site server is running with R2, and I'm about to do the upgrade of the secondary site, and that should be pretty much done in the next few minutes. And then after that, I'm going to just start upgrading my clients. Again, guys, test this out on the lab. Read some of the upgrade checklists that I put on my blog right now. Check everything in there, validate, perform test database upgrade. If you're doing this in production, I suggest you guys go ahead and do this on first before going and release this to production. All right, guys. So hopefully you enjoy my video. I know it was kind of fast. I just wanted to create a video instead of a screenshot. So happy Halloween, guys.